Engagement is a term that we use to refer to a signal that tells us that users are choosing to interact with our product, that they're finding something of value in it. It's usually an idea that we look to measure with analytics because we're looking for natural patterns of user behavior in the real world. We want to understand how much and how often people turn to our product as part of their day-to-day lives. User attention is finite, and if they're choosing to spend their time in our product, it suggests they find something valuable there. Highly engaged users tend to be more profitable, as they're more likely to make purchases or subscribe to paid services or click on more ads. Engagement is a fairly abstract concept on its own. We can't measure it directly. There's not a single metric that covers a concept that big. So we need to break engagement down into a series of more specific things that we can observe that can tell us that people are finding value. And that'll vary depending on what type of product you have. What engagement means to your team varies quite a bit on what your product is trying to do. If your product's main purpose is to gain your users' attention and interest in some way, like games, media websites, or social apps, then engagement will be measured in terms of average session length or how frequently users return. You could also get more specific and nuanced than that too. Let's say for an online game, you want to ensure that your users are having fun and feeling accomplished, not just spending hours doing tedious tasks to earn in-game currency, for example. So beyond just the average session length, you might also set up metrics related to how many quests they're completing per session or how long those quests take, because completing a quest is something that would ideally make players feel some sense of fun and accomplishment. On the Nielsen Norman Group site, we find that it's useful to know how many times on average people reread the same articles or watch the same videos more than once. That can help us understand if it's a useful resource that people like to refer to regularly. But remember, like all quantitative metrics, something like that can be ambiguous. If someone rereads the same article multiple times, it could mean that it was really useful, or it could mean that it wasn't very clear and the person needed to put a lot of effort into understanding it. One final word of caution about engagement metrics. One consequence that can happen when teams prioritize engagement as a key growth metric is that they make design choices that try and encourage habitual or even addictive behaviors in their users, such as endlessly scrolling a list of social media posts, cultivating this fear of missing out, all in the service of improving the engagement metrics. This sort of deceptive or manipulative design is something that I strongly recommend that you avoid. Users in our research have described anxiety and even shame about the lack of control they felt over their use of devices. We've even heard users call that phenomenon the vortex that's trapping them. And that's not what engagement is really all about. Engagement is about creating value for your users such that they choose to spend time with your product.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.